What's up, my fam jams? It's me, Jordan of the Fear Razor, and let me know in the comments below, do you guys want me to start calling you that? I've been tweeting it out a lot lately. Does another YouTuber use that term? I don't know. It's just been stuck in my head. Let me know in the comments below if you want me to start calling you that, or if somebody else uses it, because I would like to know that. But anyways, welcome back to another story. Guys, I'm going to just jump right into this, but quickly ask you to leave a like. I'm going to be that guy right now. And maybe can we get 12 likes? Maybe even like, you know what, if 12 is pushing it, 11 would be fine. But of course, don't forget to leave comments in the comment section below. Tell me your stories. I love reading them and stuff like that. Be a part of the community, everybody, you know? Like, there's more stories than just this video. And of course, follow me on social media, blah, blah, blah. Okay, I've rambled enough. Let's just get right into it. So guys, this story isn't the longest story, but it is still nonetheless pretty tragic. Pretty scary, actually, because it was the first time it happened. And it was, well, essentially somebody stealing money from me in a big way. So what had happened was, I recalled this happened, I want to say, maybe 2 or 3 years ago. Two or three years ago. And I had still been working a part-time or full-time job. I can't fully remember, but I was still doing YouTube as well. And I recall I was doing a few errands, and you know, it didn't really seem like I was having the best week. I honestly can't tell you why. I just don't remember having the best time. I can't remember being very happy around then. So who knows? Crippling depression is a very strange thing. But anyways, I recall I was hanging out with a friend of mine, and we had gone to Tim Hortons. If you don't know what Tim Hortons is, allow me to clarify, it is the most Canadian thing in the world. It is a symbol of all Canadians. It's essentially a Canadian Starbucks, but not as fancy. That, if I'm gonna be straight up, that's pretty much it, but it's amazing. And I went to this Tim Hortons. And, you know, it was a very simple purchase. You know, can I get a tea or coffee or whatever? And I used my debit card. And, you know, I did the whole tap thing. And it didn't go through. It was like, it said there was something wrong with it. I can't really recall what it says. Like, invalid transaction or something. Or invalid funds or something. Something really odd. Which, at first, you know, you get that little shock. You're like, ugh, what's going on? And then you do it again, and then it happens again. And I'm just like, okay, I know I have money in my bank, because at the time I had like $600 from the job I was working. So for this card to not be working right now was pretty scary. And also, I didn't have a credit card at the time, so this was all of my money. And I drove a car too, by the way. So no gas, money, or anything. So pretty terrified. And I was, you know, I'm not gonna lie, I'm always overthinking things. And I tried my best to not, you know, assume the worst. But as I was driving to the bank, which I did the next day because it was at nighttime this has happened, I had gone to the bank and had found out that all my money was gone. And, you know, I panicked because I was like, I did have money, right? And, you know, I was like overthinking. I was like wondering, did I do something? And then, you know, I just was like, no, like, I know I had money in there. I definitely did. And I went to the bank about it. And, you know, I filed the claim, and, you know, they were gonna look into it, I guess. So then, after a little, I want to say after like maybe a couple of days, I get a phone call from my bank, and they tell me that whoever had hacked the bank did not actually go into my bank account through they essentially said they had hacked through some sort of online banking site that I was a part of, and had gone in to my actual bank account through that and stole my money. So I was thinking a lot about this, and around the time I actually recall, and this was very, around this time, I'm not gonna lie, guys, like, you know, emails that are, like, pretending to be, essentially pretending to be, like, your with your bank or something, but they're actually not. which is terrifying because, you know, there are a lot of people who send emails that almost look so identical to your actual bank, which could totally trick people. And I'm not trying to tell you that I was tricked into it, but I do recall I got an email from my online bank, which turns out it wasn't, and I had clicked something. I didn't type in my password or whatever, I didn't log in, but through opening this email, it had somehow allowed these hackers to get into my online banking. And I remembered this, and I actually ended up having to call my online bank, and they had to do an investigation. And things were getting really serious, because again, you know, I was slightly doubting myself at times, because I overthink and stuff, and I just was so worried, because this was a big deal, you know, this was very illegal stuff going on, and I don't want them to say, oh yeah, you somehow screwed up. But anyways, they investigated it, and then they call me back, and they're like, okay, so, we think what had happened, because I told them about the email, that your account had been, I think it was, attacked by, phishing, or something. It's a term, I think it's called phishing, where essentially, it's spelled with a PH, I think, where they essentially, like, trick you. Pretending to be your online banking, and then they just totally go in, take stuff, leave, etc. And anyways, I had found out about this, and, you know, my online bank luckily had, reimbursed the money to me, had put the money back in, because, you know, that was technically a flaw on their behalf, since, you know, a bank should be trusted, and if they were hacked somehow, it is technically their fault. And, again, they investigated these emails as well, because around then, I don't recall these, like, emails that trick you were, like, the most common. But, like, nowadays, they just spam the hell out of your account, out of your emails. But back then, it was, like, really not common. So, I'll admit, I was slightly tricked and sort of. Not exactly, but I opened this thinking it was my actual my bank, and it wasn't. And then, you know, I got my money back, and they investigated it, and honestly, that's pretty much where the story goes. This is where it ends. I got the money back. It was a terrifying experience, but, you know, at the end of the day, you know, I got it back, and, you know, I lived on, and it certainly opened my eyes to the reality of there are people out there who are trying to get the best of you, get the better of you, and you really need to stay vigilant and smart. And, you know, if you get spam emails and stuff, and if especially, you know, you have online banking and stuff, you gotta be careful. You really do. But with that being said, though, I learned my lesson, and now, you know, I've got super crazy locks on all of my banks. So, hey, you should probably do the same if you're, like, you're skeptical about, you know, trusting stuff like that. But anyways, guys, that's the story. I hope you guys did enjoy. Not the most exciting story, but it was very real. And again, terrified the hell out of me. So, you know, be careful and stuff like that. But I hope you guys did enjoy this video. If you did, be sure to leave a like. Don't forget to subscribe. And I will see you guys in the next one. All right, guys, take care and have a great day.